Hey everyone, Siko, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here to talk about books that I think are perfect recommendations for lovers of specific TV shows. I've done a similar video in the past that was also about TV shows and books that I want to recommend for them, and I'm going to link that video down below. I also am going to link other videos that had similar concepts. I've done one for movies and one for album art. We have quite a few recommendations to get through, so without further ado, let's jump into this video. The first TV show that I want to tackle is What We Do in the Shadows, which is this incredibly funny TV show about a pack of modern vampires. It always puts me in a good mood. The humor is on point, and if you've never heard about it before, you can watch it on Hulu and then thank me later. But people that already are familiar with the TV show and love it, I recommend to pick up Soulless by Gail Carriger, which on paper seems to be a completely different type of story. It is about this woman named Alexia, who is a spinster. She lives in a Regency London, and she is a preternatural, which means she can absorb the powers of other supernatural creatures by touch alone. While the time periods are different, the tone of these two works are the same. Soulless is just as funny and campy, and it also presents supernatural creatures in a way that we don't usually expect, because I think at this point in 2021 we are used to supernatural creatures being dark and gritty, and in this book and in this TV show they are just fucking stupid. Soulless is just a fun time, and if you also enjoy a bit of romance in your fiction, you will especially like it, because Alexia does have a dislike-to-love relationship with a werewolf named Connell, who is a noble and a leader of his werewolf pack, but also is the head of the investigative agency for supernatural cases. I'm currently on book 3 myself, and I'm having a real good time with it. The next recommendation is for The Haunting of the Hill House, which is a show that a lot of people love, excluding me because I cannot watch horror. I've seen this TV show on accident, and it did make me real antsy, and I couldn't sleep for a very long time. The book that I want to recommend to the lovers of that TV show is The Little Stranger by Sarah Waters. I've recently finished it, and it gives me similar vibes, because The Haunting of the Hill House is about an old house with history that turned into a monster because all of the things that happened in it and started torturing the family that moved into it. The Little Stranger is very much similar in a way. In fact, it was inspired by The Haunting of the Hill House by Shirley Jackson. So there are a lot of elements in it that you would recognize if you've seen the TV show. It is a story that is set after the war in England, when noble families started losing money. It follows the Iris family that is trying to survive and get their old house back to its glory. The father of the family died, leaving his wife and two children to care about the house, but they are not very skilled in it. In the Hundreds Hall, the house in question started crumbling down. Something sinister apparently also makes a home in the house, because weird things start happening in the house, and the house itself is targeting one member of the family at a time. This one is a very interesting read. I specifically recommend it to people that love The Haunting of the Hill House, but also people that love character-driven stories, because while it is sinister, I would not call it gory or very scary, although I'm not an expert on it because I have a very different idea of what's scary and what's not scary. But I mostly found that what's enjoyable about this book is the family dynamic and the relationships that they built with other people, and the historical period itself and how it affects the family that lives in Hundreds Hall. The next show that I'm going to give you a book recommendation for is Peaky Blinders. The recommendation itself is going to be pretty basic. Not because the book is bad, the book is fantastic and I really want to talk about it, but because I'm gonna base it on the fact that Peaky Blinders is a show about organized crime with very interesting relationship dynamics. The book that I want to talk about in this section is Jade City by Fonda Lee, which is absolutely phenomenal. It's a fantasy. It's set on the island of Kikon, which is known for producing jade that some people on Kikon can use to make themselves stronger and to get almost supernatural abilities. The island itself is somewhat ruled by these two clans. Both of these clans lived in a semi-peace and in a healthy competition with each other until one of the clans gets a different leader and she appears to want to start a war between them. It's a series of books. I've read only the first novel, but it's so entertaining. When I wasn't reading it, I was thinking about it. The way the relationship in the clans work is very fascinating. Also, most of the leadership positions in one of the clans are filled by family members, and sometimes they butt heads and the business becomes personal, and it is just so good. One of the most interesting family dynamics that I've ever seen in fiction, and one of the most believable ones, to be fair. Highly recommend to check out this book. The next book I want to recommend is for lovers of sex education, which is a Netflix TV show that I really, really enjoy. It's about a guy whose mother is a sex therapist and who suffers greatly because of her job, and who decides to give sex therapy at his school. It honestly just happens on accident once, and then he is roped into it and starts making money out of it. So the premise of the show already is really funny to me, but also I think it has very compelling drama and characters. The book that I think is perfect for the lovers of the show is Jack of Hearts and Other Parts by Elsie Rosen. It is about a gay guy in high school that starts a sex advice column on the blog of one of his friends. The story is very interesting because it delves into the topic of gay male fetishization by straight women, usually. The characters and the writing style, though, despite the serious topic, are very jazzy and fun. The next TV show is Anne with an E, which is an adaptation of Anne of Green Gables, but the book that I want to recommend is The Good Girl's Guide to Murder by Holly Jackson. On paper, again, doesn't seem to be having the same premise. Anne with an E is about an orphan that is adopted into a family and that is living her life and is very adventurous. The Good Girl's Guide to Murder is about a teenager named Pip that decided to investigate a murder case that happened in her small village. Both of these characters, though, are the same character. They are there for the truth and justice. They are very adventurous and peppy. Pep is an amazing investigator as well. Both of them are also unquestionable optimists and believe in the best of people, which in regards to a crime story is very unusual. I really like The Good Girl's Guide to Murder, especially for this element. And I highly recommend it because even when it goes dark, you still know that this character is going to persevere. So if you like Anne from Anne with an E, you will definitely enjoy Pip from The Good Girl's Guide to Murder. Next show is Pose, which is sadly ending this year. The third season is gonna be the last season. I love the show very, very much. It's about the ball scene and the lives of people that are invested in it. And the book that I want to recommend is actually not about the ball scene, but it's close. It's about the drag scene. And it is Kings, Queens, and In-Betweens by Tanya Boteju. I love this story. It's young adult. It follows a lesbian protagonist who is struggling with her identity. Her mother left her, she doesn't really know why. She's stumbling into a drag performance one day, and it's the moment where she finally starts feeling like herself. It's a coming-of-age story, but I would like to argue that When it comes to certain characters from Pose, it was also a coming-of-age story for them. There are certain elements about identity and family that I have not seen discussed in other work, so that was also very interesting. I also really enjoyed the character and loved getting the story through her perspective. The last TV show that I'm going to talk about is Gilmore Girls. I don't think I need to tell you what the show is about because it feels like everyone had heard about it. It's about a mother and daughter that have a very unorthodox relationship. They are very quirky and fun, but also when you look closely into it, a bit codependent. The mother got pregnant at 16 and decided to raise a child on her own because her family was way too intrusive, and it's kind of a story about their lives. The book that I want to recommend for the lovers of Gilmore Girls is Tell Me How I Really Feel by Mina Mesafi. The story of these two women is retold through a different cultural perspective in this book, and also there is a queer romance in it, which is very fun. I myself was a big fan of Rory Perry's relationship in the TV series, and I know that it is unpopular, but I just found them to be fun and interesting, and in my head they were a bit more than friends, so I was very happy to see a bit of a similar relationship explored in Tell Me How I Really Feel. This is all for today. These are all the recommendations that I have. If you have any recommendations for the shows that I mentioned in this video, leave them in the comments down below. If you have any TV show recommendations, I'm always looking for more TV shows to watch. Perhaps I've watched them already, but maybe other people are looking too. If you reach this part of the video and you don't have anything to say, you can just leave an emoji of a TV in the comments down below. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you soon with another one. But until then, bye.